ladies and gentlemen. This is an update. My three inch-hot burners hooked to a 4-inch pipe into my power venter, and here we're recording about 120 degrees coming out of the supply. And what is the floor temperature?
Floor temperature, it's 57 now.
It's about 55 degrees, okay? And then we have 131 degrees coming out, 134, 135, wow, right? That's pretty neat. So I would say it's averaging 120. Now it's going on full speed. Okay? That was medium before. So even at full speed, you check the floor, it doesn't go below 120 degrees, right? Yeah, see, full RPM, and it's maintaining it between 120 and 130, trying to find a sweet spot. This is on high speed, mind you, you know, it's very high. Wow. 120 degrees and 52 degrees here, right?
Yeah.
Now put it on low. Yeah, just leave it there. It's still blowing nice hot air,
yeah.
Right? So now obviously the temperature is going to rise because it's on low speed. Wow, this would make a really nice home heater, you know, portable. Man, it should climb more because it's on low speed now.
Yeah,
we know on 120 on high speed. And this is on low. I think it takes a little while for the heat exchanger also to recover. That's what I'm thinking. See, now it's climbing up. We'll go up to 150, 170, right?
Yeah.
I'm really impressed. This little heater is really doing a good job. Wow, did you see 159, 160? It'll keep climbing up to 170. That was the maximum we reported earlier, right? Yep. 175, 180. Wow, now it's really getting hot. You know?
180.
180. Wow, and you have 52 degrees coming in. Right? Man, this is going to be the most.
Wow.
It's like sitting in front of a furnace. You know? I really can't keep my hand close to it. It's so hot. So this is on low, this is a little variac I have there, and now we're going to increase the speed to medium, and on medium, what do you have?
140, 150.
Yeah, still sustaining that much of heat, you know, 170, right?
Yeah.
And it's pushing a lot more air now. Oh wow, that's hard up to here. That's 12 inches away from it, you know?
Yeah.
Whoa, that's plenty of heat. I'm really impressed with this heater. 174, right? On medium also. Let me go ahead and turn it a little higher or make it maximum. That's full speed. Yeah, at full speed it comes up to 120. We average it, right?
Yeah.
It takes a little while for it to cool down, so I'm not gonna bore you guys. It's just that we're getting very good temperature rise between low, medium, high. And I'm really impressed with this thing. Wow. See, it's still maintaining 150 degrees.
Yeah.
Put this whole unit into the compact box in the HSO home heater. Alright? See what happens when you turn it on high? Turn the speed down now. I want to see what difference it makes in the flame.
Yeah.
See, it was drawing the flame also really hard. Now they're nice. So, yeah, we can do both ways, high, medium, low, and of course on low, it's still pretty strong here, right? That air is really hot. So anyway, we'll keep you updated. This is another project. I'm getting very excited now to put this whole thing into a box. Yep, it's gonna be again on the drawing table. And we're gonna have the next one with a portable HHO heater. It'll heat at least 2,000 square feet and no problem. At least 350, I guarantee it. It's a lot of temperature rise.
Yeah.
You know, 52 and 120 on high,
yeah.
170 on low. I mean, you're going over 100 degrees, you know, and 68 on the other, 70, right?
Yeah.
So, I was expecting 50 degrees temperature rise, but this is really exciting. Because obviously each tip is producing, I don't know, crazy, it goes too high. So I'm thinking maybe 5,000 degrees. Each tip, that's 15,000 degrees when you're coming out of this heat exchanger, right? Alrighty, we'll keep working on it. Have a good day.